Welcome to Western Sydney, where behind me in the shed here is my model railway. It's based on the LNER in the late 1930s, so come in, have a look. So here we are, welcome to Woolmer Green, my model railway. Let's get started. So the layout, as I said earlier, is based on Woolmer Green. Now Woolmer Green was a bottleneck of sorts. It was the north end of the two track to four track section over Digsville Viaduct. So you left Welland Garden City, you went over the bridge, hit Welland North, you went through the tunnel, and in the tunnel, the north portal is just off here. I haven't modelled it because there's not enough room. So it came out of the North Tunnel into Woolmer Green, where it's split into the four track section just before Nebworth. That is what I've modelled. So what you're about to see is a representation of the East Coast Mainline in the 1930s. I've used a 1936-37 working winter timetable as the basis. I've spent hours going through that and picking certain trains out and what I wanted to model. So what you're going to see is a few trains running, not the entire sequence. I have about upwards of 40 trains that move. I think you're going to see about maybe 10, 15. And eventually, when I've got a bit more work done, I'll do a full video of the complete sequence, but it's very much a work in progress. So you're going to see locos without lamps, without crew, some unpainted, some wagons unpainted. There's certain things, coaches might not be finished. So what I've done is some projects that were on my bench, I've put them into their trains and I've just ran the sequence. So what you're gonna see is just some trains running. I'm gonna do maybe a bit of audio over the top so you know what's in the train, what type of train it was, the time of day that train would have passed. So I'll stop waffling on and I hope you enjoy it. Thanks very much.
So to start off, it's about 2:10 a.m. and we have the 10:10 p.m. Eglinton to King's Cross Express Milk, hauled by a King's Cross based C1. The time's now jumped forward to 6 a.m. and we have the 1:55 a.m. New England to East Goods Yard Class B Goods, hauled by K3 of Gateshead, number 1304. It's now 6:15 a.m. and we have the 5:45 a.m. Hitchin to Welland Garden City Class A Engineers Working. It's hauled by a Retford J11 and it will stop at the signal at Woolmer Green. It's now 6:50 a.m. and we have the 6:20 a.m. Hornsey to York empty stock working, and it's hauled by Grantham based A1 2554. Now 10 minutes later at 7 a.m. with the engineer's train still sitting in its siding, we have the 6:10 a.m. Firm Park to New England Class A coal empties, hauled by K3. The LNER used K3s on some workings to get coal empties back north quicker. It's now 7:14 a.m. and we have the 6:56 a.m. hitch into King's Cross Local, hauled by an N2. Now, a few minutes later, the engineer's train sets off. It's about 7:18 a.m. It will now go into the two-track section, Foo Welland North Tunnel, Foo Welland North Station, over Diggsville Viaduct to its destination at Welland Garden City. Here we have another hitch into King's Cross Local. This departed at 7:53 a.m. and this is hauled by a King's Cross based A5 5007. It's roughly 8:05 in the morning. It's now roughly 10:30 a.m. and we have the 10:15 a.m. King's Cross to Edinburgh, the Flying Scotsman, hauled by 4489, Dominion of Canada. It's now 12:44 p.m. and we have a Fern Park to New England Class C empties heading north, whilst a York-based A1-2576, the White Knight, passes with the 10:17 a.m. Doncaster or 9:10 a.m. Hull to King's Cross passenger service.
Once it's locked in, you can pull the brightness up and down on the side.
On the side?
Yeah, I'll show you.
It's now 1:38 p.m. and we have the 10 a.m. Newcastle to King's Cross Silver Jubilee. This is the spare set, hauled by one of Haymarket's A4s, Commonwealth of Australia. At 2:35 p.m. we have an A2-2401 passing a Class D pickup goods with the Yorkshire Pullman. This loco was built by Tony Wright and painted by Jeff Haynes. The LNER made most of their money from their coal trains, particularly from the Nottingham pits and the Yorkshire pits. So it made sense to have three workings in each direction in my sequence. So here we have a 9:45 a.m. New England to Fern Park Class C coal, hauled by a colic based 04. It's roughly 2:55 in the afternoon. It's now 3:30 p.m. and we have the 3 p.m. King's Cross to Peterborough, hauled by a B2, number 5427. She's heading back to her home shed of Lincoln. Jumping forward an hour to 4:35 p.m., we have the 2:40 p.m. Finsbury Park to Huntington North Class C water train with a Grantham based J15 7515 in charge. It's now 4:55 p.m. and we have the 4:15 p.m. King's Cross to Grantham passenger service. This is hauled by King's Cross based X booster fitted C14419.
No worries.
At 5:45 p.m. we have a Peterborough to Hatfield all stations, hauled by a Hitchin-based D2 4328. The northeastern clerestory was built by Jonathan Whelans. And now the finale. It's roughly 8 p.m. and we have the 3 p.m. Hull to King's Cross goods number 1 braked fish, hauled by 4776, a York-based V2.